Hello, and today we're going to talk about traction alopecia. Traction alopecia, as you know, is common in the African community. It is also common in those who like to wear dreadlocks, like in this picture. Also, tight braids in a Congo fashion. Many communities the world over get this, but here we're going to confine ourselves to Sikh pattern traction alopecia, which is a little different subset from the other forms of traction alopecia, which are seen in other communities. So traction alopecia is an acquired hair loss pattern, which results from continued, prolonged, ongoing and repetitive hairstyles. Now these hairstyles, which are done in a repetitive manner, in the same style, day after day, year after year, lead to a typical hair loss pattern. Now in the Sikh community, what is worrying is that traction alopecia is prevalent in a very large number of the community. Young Sikh males and even some women who tie a top knot have a prevalence of up to 87.5%, which is very high. Now these same people, when they go on to wear a westernized hairstyle, they suddenly find that the hairline is broken and there is very little they can do about it, which they did not realize earlier. Now since the Sikh religion mandates upon you to wear a tight jura for life, it never occurs in the minds of the parents that tomorrow the child might regret a tight hairstyle which led to this balding pattern. Now if this condition of traction alopecia and a broken hairline is caught early on when the hair just started to thin, there it can be treated and the whole situation can be reversed. This is not so in a majority of the patient because the Sikh religion mandates upon the follower a lifelong adherence to these strict tenets, the strict laws of keeping long hair which is tied in a top knot. So once this balding pattern has formed, there is not much you can do about it because the hair will not grow back. Whatever medical treatment is given, it will not come back. In these cases, only hair transplant can save the situation. And at our center, we do a large number of Sikh pattern traction alopecia since we are situated in Punjab where the Sikh community is predominant. Now, traction alopecia need not only affect the hairline, it can affect the temples. It can affect the back of the head also because sometimes along the top knot, there is a braid, a plait which is tied at the back of the head. Now this video will show you how the Sikh top knot is tied. Please follow carefully that the hair is tied very, very tightly. And it is tied in two parts. One is in the front, the top knot, which is tied real tight. And then at the back of the head, there's a plait which is made. And this is also stretched to the maximum. And both of them are tied together. This doubles the force upon the hair on both sides, the front and the back. The hair which are most distant from the top knot will carry more force, and that is where the maximum damage is done. The maximum damage is done along the front of the hairline, the temples, and hair near the nape of the neck. This is akin to a tent with its ropes. The maximum force is exerted by the last keg where the rope is tied to secure a tent. The diagnostic feature which separates hair loss because of Sikh pattern traction alopecia and male pattern hair loss is that there is a fringe sign. There are small thin hair which are left in the fringe. Now these hair are so thin, so they are spared. So this fringe sign, as is evident here, is a diagnostic feature of traction alopecia. Also, in traction alopecia, if you see, there is a sudden transition zone from baldness to hair and a sudden transition from no hair to hair with very high density. This is diagnostic feature of traction alopecia in Sikhs. Now if you go to the description below, you will find a link to all the previous videos on Sikh pattern traction alopecia. There are a host of results, before and afters, and comb through videos which you can go through to acquaint yourself with the type of treatment that we give for our patients of Sikh pattern traction alopecia. It will also give a link to a talk which has the classification system of traction alopecia, which is very, very interesting, which you might like to see. What are the unique challenges of a case of Sikh pattern traction alopecia? Plantation of hair in traction alopecia is very different from a normal bald patient. Why? Because of these features. Number one, area which is bald might have scarring, which may be very dense. Not everyone is trained or skilled to plant hair in scar tissue. It is only a plastic surgeon who knows how to deal with scar tissue and wound healing. Hair in scar tissue can also grow almost as good as androgenic alopecia, but you have to take certain points into consideration so that the growth is thick. The second part is that since even the donor area will be affected in traction alopecia. In severe cases, more advanced cases, you might not have adequate donor area to work with. Now this is a very big challenge in some cases, because when there is no donor area, even the bald area will be very large, and to cover such a big area, you will have to do this procedure in parts, and you might also need to recruit body hair. So in advanced cases, treating traction alopecia in a sick patient with hair transplant is a huge challenge, which only select centers are skilled and experienced to perform. So traction alopecia in the Sikh community is so rampant that almost all the Punjabi film industry and the music industry, almost everyone has traction alopecia. And if you see our videos, and if you see the testimonials, and if you see the before and afters, you will see that almost every star that you are acquainted with, provided if you are a Punjabi, has had some form of traction alopecia or the other, and you can judge for yourself how we have treated it and what are the skills that have been put to use in treating celebrity traction alopecia. Take for example Rana Ranbir himself, a very popular actor. Rana Ranbir was initially only doing comedy shows. After 2013, he increasingly was accepted as a serious actor on stage and on the screen. These are the benefits of hair transplant. It completely changes your profile. There's a dramatic change of perception in the eyes of the people who watch you every day and every night. Now, Rana Ranbir is an accepted serious actor. In fact, he's a big director now in the Punjabi film industry as well. But you can see his before pictures, and you can see his present pictures, and you can compare the difference in look. He was a comedy actor earlier, and now he's a serious actor, and he's doing very well in the industry as a serious actor. Just imagine if he was without a hair transplant, would these serious roles have suited him? Perhaps not. The other example is Sherry Maan. Sherry Maan was earlier a Punjabi music star. He was only confined to music industry. The day he got a hair transplant done, he got a satisfactory result, his profile changed. You can see the hairline, and he has done numerous Punjabi movies ever since. And he has been hit as an actor as well as a pop star in Punjabi music industry today. So mostly all celebrities, even other people in various other professions, are today reaping the huge benefits of hair transplant in Sikh pattern traction alopecia, which was initially thought as an indication where hair transplant will not work because of the scarring. But with increasing skill development, increasing knowledge of traction alopecia, the pathology of scarring in traction alopecia, we have acquired skills and the capability to give you a head full of hair in traction alopecia. Now, what are the signs of traction alopecia? When traction alopecia begins, it will lead to a little bit of itching, which is constant itching. Later on, there will be a little reddish discoloration and pimples will appear. And soon, when this evolves, when the pull is not lessened, you don't change the hairstyle, there will be balding, which will appear in the fringe area, the furthest area. And slowly, the hairline will recede back in a typical fashion along the front of the head, the temples, and along the hair in the nape of the neck. To an extent where, after some time, if the pull is not relieved, if the hairstyle is not changed, the balding will become irreversible and permanent. And the only solution henceforth would be a hair transplant, and no medical treatment will work. So here is an advice to mothers who are rearing their children to be good Sikhs and tie a top knot. If you have to tie a top knot, please do not tie it very tight. Do not tie it right in the front. Go a little bit back and tie the top knot. And tie it pretty loose. Do not use any rubber band to further tighten it. And please do not braid the back of the head and tighten it to secure it. Another thing, do not tie the top knot when the child's hair is wet. The knot becomes very, very tight. The pull increases, the stretch increases. When a tight knot is tied in dry hair, there is very little chance that the hairline will be so disrupted as in hair which is wet and a top knot is tied. This is an important take-home point for mothers who do top knot. Another thing, when you sleep at night, please loosen your top knot. This will give the skin 8 to 10 hours to heal, and the balding, because of traction alopecia, will not be so intense as it would be if the pull is continuous for 24 hours. Tying a top knot, even amongst non-Sikhs, is becoming a fashion these days. If you're in Manhattan and you walk by the street, you will see number of people going with top knots, and they're not all Sikhs. The top knot is a huge fashion statement today in the Western world. However, it is only in the Sikh patients that we find traction alopecia. Why? Because of tying a tight top knot in a peculiar fashion in which it is tied amongst the Sikh community. So this was about Sikh pattern traction alopecia. If you have any questions for me, you can write the questions in the comment section below and I'll be happy to reply back to you. But if you want to share pictures and if you want to ask me for a customized plan for your traction alopecia, please send me a mail at my email drbhatti@darlingbuds.com or on my WhatsApp 981-453-1111. Thank you for watching and I'll come back to you again because we have lots of time during this COVID lockdown to do a video a day. Take care.